and today we are with Mrs. Anne-Claude Toral, who is the Managing Director of MonPanama, the hand-woven hat from Ecuador. Good afternoon to you, Anne-Claude.
Good afternoon, Stephen.
Now, Panama hats, for some reason, they're one of the most famous hats in the world. Why is that?
Panama hats have a very long history, actually. Even before the conquistadores, they went to Ecuador, the people from Ecuador were weaving hats. Not hats like these hats you see here, but hat gear. And when the Spanish people arrived in Ecuador, they were really impressed with these special hat gear, and they were thinking it was a vampire skin. And that was the beginning of the Panama hat story, when the Spanish came and really loved this hat, then brought them to Spain, where the royal Spanish family started to wear them. And more hats were exported to Europe, the United States. Then there was also the very special time in Hollywood, where a lot of film stars were wearing them. So this is, you know, this is the story of the famous Panama hat, and nowadays it's exported worldwide.
Now, here we are in Thailand. You run this company here in Thailand. How much are you selling? How many do you sell every year? And is it on the increase here in Thailand?
So I started doing this around approximately 4 years ago, and it has been going really well. So more and more people love hats, want to have a genuine Panama hat, especially here in Thailand, but also in other countries like Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar now. So yeah, it's a nice product for this region who is kind of discovering it.
What makes a Panama hat different from other hats?
So it's the material. The paja toquilla grows in Ecuador, in the Manabí province, next to the Pacific Ocean, where the climate and the soil is special. So the characteristics of the paja toquilla is it's strong, flexible, and very soft. And it is long, it grows long in Ecuador. So that's what you need when you want to weave hats. So actually the Panama hat is only woven in Ecuador. Can I ask you a question?
Yes, of course.
Do you know why it's called Panama hat and not Ecuadorian hat?
Well, this is one of the questions I was going to ask you. My answer to your question is no, I don't. Please explain.
Right, okay. So in the old days, it got shipped from Panama. So it got shipped on ships, and it went to the United States and Europe. And so the people in Europe and the United States thought that this hat was from Panama. This is one reason. The other reason was also during the construction of the Panama Canal, many engineers, including the President Roosevelt, was wearing the Panama hat. And when all these pictures went around the world, people were thinking that this hat comes from Panama.
Now, you have many different varieties of hats.
Yes.
Your company is MonPanama, and you have under that you have hand woven. Could you tell us how are your hats made here, and how do your hats differ from other people's Panama hats?
Okay, so you have different grades in Panama hats. They are always made with the paja toquilla, so the raw material is the same. But then it's all about the tightness of the weave and the skills of the artisan. And there are some villages in Ecuador where they are more famous than other villages. But in the end, it's all about the tightness of the weave. So the tighter the weave, the higher the quality, the more expensive the hat.
Now, someone like myself who knows nothing about hats, how would I be able to go into a shop and say, I can tell this is a better quality one than this one? How would I be able to learn and see
this? It takes time. So it takes years, actually. You have to look at many hats. Normally, the way you look at a hat when you buy a hat, this Panama hat, is you hold it towards the light of the sun and you look inside the crown. And then you look for imperfections. If there are stains, holes, bumps, it's no good. You shouldn't buy. It should be really regular and tight. And if you see circles, the more circles, the better. For example, the very famous Montecristi hat, you will read and count the number of circles inside the crown.
Yeah. The more circles, the better.
Yeah.
And in terms of, for example, what costs are we looking at here? Because this all sounds very elite, very expensive.
So you can get from very cheap to super expensive. You can get Panama hat here in the region for 100 US, and then it can go up to 5,000. For example, this is a Montecristi, which is a very fine hat. It takes around 2 to 3 months to weave it. by one single weaver who is normally living in Pile or in other villages around Montecristi. And so this is a very special hat. Not many people are capable of weaving that quality of hat. So the price go up. It's very special. It's like a piece of art.
It is. Now, and this hat you're holding now, how much is that selling for here in Thailand?
Around 3,000 US.
$3,000.
Yeah.
And how long can somebody expect it to last for?
Forever.
Forever.
You just take care a little bit, avoid water, rain, keep it in your box, store it in your box. And when you wear a Panama hat, when you put it on your head, the way you wear it is you take the brim, you put it on your head, and you pull down the brim. You avoid touching the crown, which is a sensitive. And then when you want to remove it, the same, you put it in the box, and that's it.
Now, $3,000 is a lot of money to some people. In fact, it is a lot of money, full stop. Do you need to treat the hat? It's not just simply how to hold it. Do you also need to treat it like wood or anything like that?
No, so the climate here in Southeast Asia is perfect for these hats because it's quite humid. If it's too dry, like sometimes in Europe, the hats can crack. So dry climate, you need sometimes to humidify the hats, but actually Southeast Asia is a perfect climate for the Panama hat because the paja tokia grows in the jungle, right? So it likes water.
What percentage of the hats that you're selling here in Thailand are going to women compared to those that you've just shown us there with the Monte Cristo, which I believe is for a man?
So I have many designs. Some are unisex, some are more for ladies. Depends the design, but a lot of women like actually unisex design. So the fedora, for example, is a design I sell really well. So it depends. Customer have to try them on, look at themselves in the mirror, check the size, and then just feel comfortable about it.
Now, of course, when you're talking about $3,000 for one single hat, a lot of people will talk about customization in terms of size. Are they able to get their hats custom made? And is it even more expensive, or does the $3,000 include a custom tailored size hat?
This includes the custom made. What happens is that I will need time, because I need to contact my contacts in Ecuador, and they will need to weave it, and this can take between 3 to 6 months. Yeah, it's not something I can order and have it the next week.
Is it possible, let's say, so if somebody's coming here to Thailand to see you, they're coming for business, they want to see you, they can sit down with you 3-6 months in advance, and then 6 months later when they come back for business, they can pick up their hat
That's
at that
right.
time. And is there any regulations in terms of exporting the hats or anything like
no,
that?
No, it's considered luxury goods when I import to Thailand, but there are no other requirements.
Are you able to ship them, send them by mail or by courier as well?
Depends. For example, a Monte Cristi only with FedEx, but yeah, I would be a bit careful with that quality of hat. But the other hats, yeah, I can ship them anywhere around Asia, no problem.
Now, a lot of hotels now, they're looking for niche boutiques. Recently at the Ritz-Carlton in Bali, I saw a perfumery where you can go in and learn about perfume, and you can even make your own perfume. Is this something that you're looking to do with hotels here in Asia, where you set up a boutique and people come to the boutique to have their own hat made at the hotel?
Actually, I do this already. I have a few corners in some really beautiful hotel boutiques, and I train the staff. So I do really a very detailed training where I tell them about care instruction, looking at the sizes, how to measure the head size of the customer, explaining about different shapes, design, grades, so that they are very self-confident when the customers are asking questions. And I help, of course, with the visual merchandising, with the packaging. I also do customization. So I have hotels, they contact me and they want their own brand. So I do this. Instead of putting my pin, I would put, for example, here the pin of the hotel, and then instead of having my brand on the packaging, I would have the brand of the hotel. Yeah, I do this. Yeah.
So that's perfect for loyalty guests, whether the hotel wants to reward its loyalty customers,
correct,
or also for a corporate gift as well.
Also, yeah, correct.
And in terms of the hats themselves, like we mentioned, women's hats, there's all different styles. What is the most favorite women's hat?
So uh, a hat I sell quite well is this one for women. I call it the Coco. It has a wide brim and a round crown. So this is one of my good sellers with women. Another one I sell well is this one. It's called the Diana Bleached. It's a fine hat, white, so bleached, premium. And then this is another hat I sell well. It's called the Vizier. So it's also good, some air can come into the head, yeah.
Now, let's say the visor there, because I've seen that's very popular. One of my friends has one of them. How much is that visor, for example, the one that we're looking at there?
This one is around 4,500 baht.
I nearly had a heart attack. I thought he was going to say dollars. So half of it's missing. So that's 4,500 baht.
No, for the Montecristi, I talk in dollars, but for the rest of the hats, I talk in baht.
So that one's very reasonable. That's 4,500 baht. Okay. And how long would that take to make?
Depends, because it's not only the weaving, it's then also the finishing of the hat. So maybe the weaving a couple of days, but then you need to finish it, put the hat band, put the brand. So it can take up to a few weeks.
Now, if somebody's watching this and thinks, right, I'm coming to Thailand on business, I want to treat my wife, I would like to treat my girlfriend, I'd like to treat myself. How do they get in contact with you?
So I have a showroom in Ekamai, that's where I live, that's where I have my showroom. And then you can find me on Instagram, Facebook, MonPanama. And yeah, I meet anybody by appointment.
Excellent. Well, I have to say, Anne-Claude, thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and MonPanama the best of luck for the future.
ขอบคุณมากค่ะ.
Thank you.